Mobile and the Florida Panhandle and into Georgia. The European model has it slowing down, heading northwest, gaining strength and becoming a potential hurricane. This could become a major storm and hit land again anywhere from Gulfport to New Orleans. Hazel is moving at approximately 10 miles per hour and should make landfall late tonight or early tomorrow morning. As Hazel makes landfall, she's going to become a tropical storm once again and bring plenty of rain and high winds to wherever she hits. Now, folks, I feel that Hazel is most likely to head towards our friends in Louisiana.
Gorgeous.
What's in there?
In that?
Yeah.
Nothing.
Define nothing.
Some shows.
But the molt was over.
It was, and then it wasn't. But those are for fragments.
What, so they could be drowned in garlic and black pepper? Can't even taste them.
They offered 55 a dozen.
I'll give you 60.
Some people would be okay with that?
Kidding? We cold soft shell this late.
If anyone asked, you can get those from me.
Get what? Careful out there this weekend.
Thanks.
Things are complicated enough with him being my boss and all.
Look, just stay safe tonight. Okay, I hear Hazel's gonna turn.
I bet she hangs 11 pounds of straight on.
I said I wanted a pony. Since when?
Since always.
I told you not to let her watch Black Stallion.
You didn't eat your lunch.
Nobody brought that anymore. Why can't I just buy food at school?
You can every once in a while, but it adds up. We've been over this.
So stupid.
Okay, talk to me. What's going on?
Kate Riley's having a party the same night as me. They're gonna have freaking food trucks.
Wow.
I don't even want a birthday. I'm never gonna get what I want anyway, so what's the point?
Okay. We can't afford a computer right now, but it might be something for Christmas.
Right. We'll be lucky to have a tree. You're not supposed to be on the phone.
I wasn't going to answer it. I just want to see who it was. I'm expecting a call from the bank.
So it's Carol. That's the bank. Oh my god. You're on a first name basis with the bank.
Please stop being so dramatic.
Just answer the phone and
ask if I can call her back.
Jesus. Oh my god, mom! You're not just the worst driver in the whole world.
It's because no one else in the entire world has you as a passenger. I'm so sorry. It was totally my fault.
Your hair, it's okay.
Well, all that I need
is an adequate
deductible for the fine.
Ah, looks like you got the bra there.
There goes my deductible.
Hey, don't waste your insurance on this. If you just have a little duct tape, spray foam, I can fix this.
I can't ask you to do that.
My dad is a mechanic. Hey, whatever you want, no real deal.
Cool. I mean, we're just up the road.
I'll follow you.
Thanks.
Yeah.
He's not going to sue us, is he?
No.
Why is he taking it over?
Because he's already come over to fix it.
You're looking to follow us home.
You know, I realize I never got a chance to introduce myself. Ray Johnson.
Miranda Wells.
Miranda, nice to meet you.
Yeah, no, not really, but I appreciate the gesture. This is Missy and Bessie.
Hi, guys.
What's the V stand for?
The V? Oh, Vanderbilt. I teach engineering up there.
Cool.
Oh, you got your hands full, huh?
You have no idea. And that's Greg.
Hey, Greg.
Hey, Mom, what happened to the bumper?
Karma. But Mr. Johnson here says he can fix it.
Yeah, you wouldn't happen to have a few screwdrivers and some wrenches in your tool shed, would you?
Of course.
And how about some spray foam? You know, the kind you used to fill a hole or stop a leak?
Tire foam or brake stuff?
Either will do.
Tire to what or brake what?
Shop talk.
Do you want a beer or water or a few spots?
No, this will just take a second.
Okay. Well, I'll leave my door open if you need anything. Just holler.
Thank you.
Let me guess. Red beans and rice, or microwave chicken nuggets and a salad.
What would you prefer, lobster tails?
What about you?
I want pizza, not tonight, honey.
Missy, come here. Greg is in deep heaven.
What do you expect? We're concerned by girls. How much are you paying this guy anyway?
Nothing.
You got it. You go down your room for her, and she runs into you? It's pretty weird.
Is it?
Okay, girls. Wash your hands.
Okay.
I should be gone.
Oh, yeah. No. Of course. Sorry. Thank you.
You smashed his truck. Ask him to stay.
Tucker is hardcore buying the love right now, and he's so good.
His family owns a restaurant and whatever they do. And I run it. And him too, I guess.
She just likes to call him a boyfriend because he's 43.
Eat your pizza.
He sounds like a kind man who recognizes a good person.
Are you like a Buddhist or something?
Let's see, what kind of question is that?
I don't know. You're so different. But like, Mom, I'm always stressed.
I'm not always stressed.
You so are.
Bessie, will you back me up here? I'm always stressed.
Yes.
Traitor.
You're exhausted the minute you wake up.
Okay, all right, I see how it goes. Everybody gang up on Mom, who works all day, and his friends like Tucker, and if it wasn't for her, you might as well be eating microwave plastic.
Yeah, what he said. Cheers.
Cheers.
You guys are funny.
Okay, one more time. She's just gonna say.
And no, I'm not a Buddhist. I just am open to the possibility that whatever happens, even the bad stuff, can lead to better things.
Not in this house.
Leave it to a hurricane to ruin a perfectly made house.
You're not driving back to Nashville tonight, are you?
No, not tonight. No, I got a place downtown. Look, listen. About today, I just want to say that everything was, I don't know, really unexpected. I meant to say something earlier, but the timing just seemed up.
Okay, guys. Watch your feet. Watch your feet. Mom, are you okay? I'm trying to be. But what are we gonna do? If the cereal's dry, grab a bowl and eat something before the milk goes bad.
Why does this always happen to us?
We're unlucky, I guess. Come on, let's get you some Cheerios. One, two.
It's in 5 days.
We'll figure it out.
How?
Look at this place. I think we should cancel. No. 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 I know you think that parents have all the answers, but we don't. Not by the longest shot. But you know what? You only turn 16 once. And we're gonna have a party. Where'd you get the coffee?
So it looks like these two rafters are split. Otherwise, it's a clean hole.
Meaning what exactly?
Hey, Greg.
Hey, guys. So to reskin this section, I don't know, it'll be about 150, and then the 2x10s, a roll of tar paper, some nails, still less than 200, and sheetrocking the ceiling and re-insulating, maybe another 200.
What's he doing here? He's fixing the roof.
How? What broke, remember?
I don't know. Magnets.
Oh, look. Nina's here.
She didn't panic at anything.
Look at this mess. What did I tell you about that house? Who is that?
Oh, that's Greg.
He's gonna fix the roof, just like he fixed Mom's bumper.
Yeah, pizza with us.
What pizza?
A step crust. Yes, Greg is going to try to fix the roof. Greg,
is he licensed?
He's from Tennessee. Can you say hello to my mother-in-law, Bobby? Bobby.
Bray, nice to meet you.
I thought I knew.
Mom smashed into him with the van.
I didn't smash into him. I tapped his bumper.
And you're still off.
What's the verdict?
I'm going to swing by the lumber yard, pick up some materials, also see if I can snag a blower to get those floors dry.
Well, we'll be here.
I know you won't. These children can't stay here.
Why not? Their bedrooms are dry.
Honey, I have two words for you. Black mold. And Greg is sick already, as it is.
But what about school?
The power's out, and the radio said they closed it overnight.
Yes!
Why not spend a few nights with me and just maybe come up with a plan?
Sure. You're right. Why don't you guys go pack up some clothes? We're gonna go to Nana's. 2 minutes you have. Don't pack everything. Go on! Thank you.
Thank you, honey.
Do you think we could stop at a restaurant on the way out? I want to check on Tuck.
Who is this complete stranger that you are trusting your own with?
Not everyone is a serial killer, Bobby. I mean, he's a college professor, for goodness sake.
Well, you can't be too careful these days.
The only thing of value in that house are the kids, and they're coming with us. So I'm just going to believe that he's not going to screw us, and he's going to do the best job he can.
Have you met people lately?
So we'll get out of here then.
You can't worry about you.
Well, we're all used to playing defense around here. But I appreciate what you're trying to do.
What am I trying to do?
Guess so. But I'm trying to raise my kids to be realistic. And their father was a dreamer, and apparently that's genetic, especially with Greg, and I just want to keep their feet firmly planted on the ground.
Roger that.
And your next question is about my husband, but you're too polite to ask. He died just 5 years ago.
I'm sorry, Julie.
Me too. He's really missing out.
We should exchange numbers, right?
Yes, of course.
Working on it. We're gonna head to Bobby's for a few days.
You'll come to stay with me.
Do you want to tell her that?
Hell no. She'd never forgive me, and I'm trying to stay on her good side. Who's doing your roof?
Oh, just a guy you don't know.
Okay.
Somebody get them settled, and I'll borrow her car, and I'll come back and help
them. No. You take care of business. I'll call you later.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
See you, Bob.
Has Tucker lost weight? He looks good.
Nope, I don't think so.
Any developments I should know about?
Why not the boat?
Because he's a good man. I know that's a strange thing for a mother-in-law to say, but I also know that you know it can be hard to move on. And I'm a widow, too, remember?
I just don't see the point in forcing something that neither one of us needs or wants.
Yeah.
yeah, this whole section's gonna have to be replaced.
Yeah, I'm gonna resheet and repave for tomorrow. Forecast says there's no rain coming, so.
Oh, good. But you're not licensed.
No, no, I'm just lending a hand.
I'll try to check with me. I would pay to hire a real roofer. No offense.
Not taken.
She's still in LA.
How long have you two been together?
A few years. She came to work for me about a year after her husband died. Good guy, too, from what I hear.
That must have been really painful. Widowed, three kids.
I think it's made her more cautious. I'm the same way. Why I haven't pushed things further, you know?
Right? Things can change if you want them to.
I just want her to be happy.
Can't say I blame you.
All right, well, nice meeting you, Frank.
Yeah, yeah, you too, Tucker.
Can you shout if this gets to be too much?
Will do.
Why do people like puzzles?
They don't. They just need something to do when they're bored.
Oh, you make this sound like prison.
Look at all these pieces. This is gonna take us a week.
Now look, I know you love that house, but I think...
Well, can we not do this right now?
I was in real estate for 40 years. That place could sell in a day. Or it could take a year and a half. You don't have that kind of time.
It's too much for me to think about right now.
Well, that's all I'm asking, that, you know, since you think about it. I mean, y'all on top of each other. Those girls need another bedroom. You can get your money out. And then some.
Not with a hole in the roof.
Oh, honey. You and I both know that that house is a teardown.
Hi.
Hey, I thought you might like a status update.
Only if it's good news.
Well, I ran out of daylight, but once the power comes back on, it should be done day after tomorrow.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, I got rid of that limb. I did a little triage on the hole. The floor seemed fine, but I'm still gonna run the blower all night just to make sure.
Oh, I don't care about that, just as long as we're dry.
All right, well, I'll check back in tomorrow.
Wait, Ray. What are you doing right now?
I'm sitting on your roof, taking in this gorgeous sunset. You?
It's stressing.
Is it about the money?
No, it's everything. My job, kids, Tucker. I think I might actually have to sell the house.
Ooh, that's a
no kidding, I just know somebody's gonna scoop it up and tear it down, and it just breaks my heart.
Well, look, when the time is right, you know what to do.
Is that another one of your life lessons?
I went through a divorce 10 years ago. It really knocked me on my ass.
Were there kids?
No, we wanted to save up a little money before starting family, and it turns out she started one with somebody else.
Oh my god, that... You must have...
Devastated. Yeah. And then I got angry and started blaming everything on everybody else.
That doesn't sound like you.
Not anymore. That was before.
Before
another kind of wake-up call.
Oh. Well, I didn't mean to cry.
No, you didn't. It's just that sometimes the best thing to do is wait till everything becomes clear.
Well, that's great news about the house, Professor. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a good evening.
Good night.
Good night.
home.
I heard you extended your stay.
Yeah, I'm just trying to make myself useful to a friend up in Madisonville. Which reminds me, I'm expecting a pretty important package in the next few days. Could you keep your eyes open for it?
Important package. You got it.
Thanks. Oh, Bobby. What are you doing here?
We're helping Mommy.
North Shore Food Bank put out a call and Miranda thought you might be able to help.
There are a lot of people on this side of the lake without power. Didn't think you'd mind putting all this to good use.
Oh, yeah, sure. Of course. But I could ask Manny or Charmaine to help. You didn't have to come in.
Oh, well, it is a work day.
Well, maybe she just missed you. You ever think of that?
You did?
What?
Nothing.
So after we drop this off, we're going to skedaddle. I'll call you later.
You know, I thought I might show Miranda that new housing development out by me. You know, because she's thinking about selling her place.
You are?
No. I checked Zillow this morning. Lots of listings. But after the storm, yours is going to stand out. I'm just saying, it's all.
If we move, how will Santa know where to find us?
Oh, honey. When you move, Mommy will fill out a change of address card, and the post office will send that straight to the North Pole.
What's wrong with our house?
Oh, everything, sweetheart. Bobby.
I gotta go. Payroll doesn't stop just because the power's out.
I'll call you later.
Okay, thank you. Let's go easy on that pet roller. I'll give you the sneezes.
When everything's cold and it's cut and I'm broken inside, I've been holding the ends of my rope with feels like forever. And the world crashes down on me and I still don't know.
Crunch?
Now, that is protein. That's good for muscles.
We usually just have cereal.
Fresh out of cereal. I'm sorry, honey.
This bread tastes gross.
Well, that's because it's gluten-free. And when you get to be my age, you will thank me.
What's gluten?
That's a thing in food.
Hmm. Hey, gang. The power's back on at the house and the roof is fixed.
Oh, no, already.
Pretty impressive.
What exactly is that thing on the roof?
Weatherproof band-aid.
Where'd it come from?
Just appeared.
Like the pizza?
No. That was because of Tucker, and this is because Bray worked really, really hard to find something that would fit.
I was probably floating around the bayou, waiting to be useful, and then it found me.
Or it was just a coincidence.
Coincidence is God's way of remaining anonymous.
Who said that?
Einstein.
E=MC² guy?
He also said that every person should ask themselves, is this a friendly universe?
Why?
Well, because your answer determines your life.
Are you sure you're not from California?
No, ma'am.
So, you're saying the magnet in your head connects you to that piece of fiberglass?
Okay, that's enough questions. This man has a life. Say goodbye to Bray.
Hi, Bray. Thank you for the roof.
Let me get my checkbook.
Okay.
Let's go to my room.
Can I ask you a question?
Shoot.
What happened to the envelope?
I haven't given it to her yet.
Why not?
Well, I put it in the mailbox after the pizza, but it flew away. So I had to get a new one.
What's in it?
Grown-up stuff. Definitely something good.
Here you go. $500 very grateful dollars. Just do me a favor and don't cash it until next week.
Understood.
So you're off to Nashville?
Yeah, I pretty much got my hands full until winter break.
I still don't understand why you helped us.
I think you and I collided for a reason. And who's to say? Maybe we helped each other.
Miranda? Honey? It's Todd.
Oh, will you tell him I'll call him back?
He says it's urgent.
Excuse me. Hi. Can I call you back in like 2 minutes? Okay. Sure, let me check. Tucker wants to take us all out for the reopening. And he wants to know if you want to come.
Oh, what an effort.
Great, we'll see you at set. Okay, bye. So you were saying? Something about us colliding for a reason?
Yeah, well, maybe it was just a chance for me to meet a really cool woman. Doing a hell of a job raising 3 kids on her own.
Thank you. Although, I think I got the better end of the deal.
Oh, hey, listen, I still have the chainsaw for another day. If you want me to free up your van, I can swing by on my way out tomorrow. I can use the car.
By all means.
Oh, honey, Tucker can do it.
Tucker with a chainsaw? Okay. But I'm making the coffee.
Deal.
Everybody, if I could have your attention, I'd like to take this opportunity and thank Manny and all of his peeps for working their butts off to get this place up and running again. Manny! Every now and then, the storm comes along and it not only rattles your business, but it rattles your life and the choices you've made in that life. I've always wanted family. For whatever reason, it just wasn't in the cards. You know, maybe I focused too much on the business. But I would like to change that. Right here and right now. Miranda Wells, will you marry me?
Yes!
sorry.
You know, let's just try. We'll just put it in.
Whatever. She said yes. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Woo. Love that. Right. Hey, what happened to your van?
Oh, it's still stuck behind a tree.
But not to worry. Our handyman's gonna chop it up first thing in the morning.
My handyman?
Hey, why don't I spend the night at the house? So you two lovers can celebrate your engagement.
Yeah, that would be terrific.
Yeah, you guys don't mind if Nana stays over, right?
Yeah, sure.
I'll see you in the morning.
Hey, I'm going to talk to Doug for one second. Kids, do not stay up all night long. Hey, Doug.
Congratulations, hon.
Thank you.
Well, let's get in the car.
Nice lady.
Keep them closed. I got you. Keep them closed.
Okay.
Almost there. And open. I spoke to Doug. I told him I wanted it here first thing this morning, and boom, here it is.
Tucker.
I cannot have my fiance driving around in some old minivan. What would the neighbors think? Huh?
Wow. It's beautiful. Thank you.
You like it? It's not too small, like the ring?
I just need to get that sized.
Well, let's go do that right now.
I can't, babe. I have to run errands before work.
What errands?
I have to get it together before Missy's party.
Party?
Her 16th birthday, silly. She talked about it last night.
Right, yeah, sorry. I was a little distracted.
No, she's worried all of her friends are going to another party that has food trucks.
Well, I can get a food truck.
No. She doesn't need a food truck. She needs balloons and a cake.
Well, what should I get her?
Oh, nothing, just a heart.
That says what?
Thank you.
You still want to throw it out?
No way.
Let me tell you something. All your dad ever wanted was for you to be happy.
How would you know that?
Well, because dads are like that.
Tomorrow, same day as mine, and she's having food trucks, and she's the most popular girl at school.
Okay, let me ask you a question. What would you rather have? 200 Instagram friends or 5 real ones?
5 real.
And are they coming here tomorrow?
Yep.
Okay, then focus on having a good time with them.
Doing what?
I don't know. What would make you happy? Not your friends, you. Wait, if you don't know what you want, how can you ask for it?
Taffy. We used to make taffy when I was a kid. All of us. Mom loves taffy.
Oh, there you go. And now that you've got all this firewood, maybe have a bonfire down by the water, or some hot dogs, make s'mores.
How do you know about s'mores?
You don't get this old without living.
Mom, what the heck? Tucker.
Wow, that's a lot of firewood.
I hear congratulations are in order.
Imagine my surprise.
Mom, can we make taffy?
Taffy?
Tomorrow, for my party. There may only be 6 of us, but who cares? And you're totally coming, right? You have to. Mom, tell me how's to.
I don't know what we're talking about. You better be there. What did you do?
No clue.
Yeah, right.
Well, I'm just gonna finish cleaning up and we'll get out of your hair.
Keeping an eye on your mother.
How come?
That's what you do when you love someone.
Then I'm gonna watch you watch them.
I'm all done watching.
Oh,
same as it did last night.
You are a very lucky girl.
Aren't I, Jess?
Not many men would be willing to take on somebody with your baggage.
Well, that's an awful thing to say.
Why? It's true. I mean, 3 kids, a mountain of debt.
It's not a mountain.
Well, it's not a molehill either.
You make me sound like some sort of charity case.
I just don't want you to... Oh, forget it.
No. What?
Blow this.
I have been in cage a whole 12 hours and already... Are you tired of living under a cloud?
Nobody ever said that life was easy.
I don't want it to be easy. But I do want it to be worth it. Bobby, when are you going to stop making everything about loss and fear rather than gain and joy?
Mom, come see what I built.
Kathy?
Yeah, it's gonna get messy, so don't wear anything too nice.
Where is this coming from?
Ray got her talking, and she realized that she just really wants to have fun.
He's gone, right?
Yeah. No, she invited him, so.
To a children's birthday party dressed as what, a clown?
That wasn't very nice.
It wasn't meant to be. I think it's weird.
He helped me, he helped Greg, he helped Missy.
Now he's helping himself to my fiance.
You're being ridiculous.
Am I?
He's a family friend, and he's coming to the party. Get over it.
Well, I think I'll just go see if he needs some help with the fire.
it was such hard work.
Yeah. Mom keeps her own stash in the glove box.
Which I noticed is getting smaller and smaller.
You snooze, you lose.
I remember this candy store right by LSU that I discovered back when I was going to be a nurse.
You? A nurse? No.
You mean, was I actually a human being before I became a mother?
Yes.
Soon to be again, I hope.
Wait, what?
Miranda? Could I talk to you inside for a moment?
Sure. I can flash.
I want to show you this. What am I looking at? A sensor. Identifies and redistributes wasted energy into a grid that can reassign the loss into a gain. Does that sound familiar?
It sounds like one of Maddie's projects.
Honey, this is Maddie's project.
Bobby, saving energy is not a new thing.
He called you from the hotel. He told you he had
just wanted to take the heat from the house.
He wanted to introduce them to some people.
It's not like he had a cat.
That's why he got on the damn plane.
So somebody else came up with it. So what?
Well, not somebody. Running. Next time you might want to Google a man you run into. That was page two.
I don't understand.
Your handyman was at the same convention. This is who Maddie was talking about. That's the thief that stole my son's invention.
You don't know that.
Oh, no, go ask him.
Are you
Yep.
I'm afraid I'm gonna have to charge you for the night.
I understand.
Keep it on the same card?
Please. Oh, and would you have a messenger deliver that tomorrow morning? You can go ahead and charge that to my room too.
Sure.
Good luck with the LSAT.
Thanks. I'll need it.
Let me ask you something. Can you see yourself being a lawyer?
Yeah, definitely.
But so can I.
I figured why make him pay for a messenger when I live like 5 minutes from here.
Thank you so much.
Have a good day. That Brett?
Yeah.
Oh, finally.
What do you mean?
He had that within the day I stayed home from school. I thought he was from the bank.
Greg, why didn't you say anything?
I'm not supposed to talk to strangers, remember?